topic that is so hard to talk about, yet it's part of life, it's inevitable. We will all die. Come one day, I won't exist in this world anymore. Neither will you, neither will your parents, neither will mine, and neither will your pet. Death is gonna happen to all of us. And we don't know exactly how it's gonna happen, even if you think about it. You never know if you're gonna die in an accident, or in a fire, or you'll get killed, or if you're lucky, I guess, old age. But there's a certain kind of death that most of us don't think about. The kind of death that is caused by our own hands. Most of us don't ever think about it. I am gonna be the one who gets to end my life. You never think I'm gonna kill myself, and that's how I'm gonna die. No. Most of us actually, I think, assume that we will die old age, in old age, and it will never be in our own hands. And that's great, really. That's how I think life ought to be. But on the side of things is, there are those of us who do think of killing themselves. And it's never like an everyday thought. It's never that they wake up and think, oh, today I'm going to kill myself. No, at least I don't think it happens that way. I think that it encroaches. It sips in slowly. You can feel. And a doctor will say that wounded suicide are caused by mental illnesses, say depression, and if you're going through hard times, say you lost somebody, or you are depressed, for whatever reason, be it causes from the environment or that you're in, or just, they say that it's a chemical imbalance in the brain, where there are certain factors that will predispose you to depression and some other mental illnesses. And as a result, death can be one thing that happens when somebody is depressed or is going through difficult times. And is the one that hurts the most. Because in the society where I come from, when I was young, I was told that suicide is a crime. And that any person who kills themselves definitely goes to hell. And I remember thinking, why? Why would they go to hell? I mean, my first feeling is words, sadness. Sadness for the fact that there are people who feel that they need to die. They deserve to die. And when I was younger, it didn't make sense because life was amazing. And I wouldn't want to go and play outside. And if it's an adult, who do you want to wake up to it and go to a job or have a family or have and kids and life back then seemed really great, like a really great idea. Like the only time anybody deserves to die is when they get old. Because that is life. You get born, you live, and then you die. When you're old. But as I grew, they say that in your early 20s, childhood traumas hit you, and most suicides are committed by young adults. And now that I'm one, it makes a whole lot of sense. Don't get me wrong. In the world that we live in, there's so much that happens to you and to others. And for some people, it tends to happen a bit too much. Too much agony, too much pain, too much suffering. And on the outward, if you look around you, we all seem to be doing fine, don't we? In our flash clothes, in our presentation of ourselves to the world, we look fine, we look good. We want to look good. But are we feeling good? Because to be honest, I don't always feel good. There are days when I just don't feel bad. I feel awful. I feel like my skin is too tight. I feel like my body is in the wrong place. My soul is dying. And my mind it's like it has this little troll, if I can much as it's my friend sometimes, like, turns against me and says all these awful things. It reminds me of the terrible things that have happened to me. It worries about the future, if there is any. And I don't know how many times I have been able to rise above these things, and I don't know how long I will do that. But I'm gonna do it for as long as possible. I'm gonna rise above this darkness, above this emptiness, above this dullness, above this grayness. And if you go through the same one verse, we're not comparing, we're not competing, but we are in this together. You are not alone. You're not the only one who feels bad or crazy or angry. Or sad, or nothing at all. I do, and so do a lot of people. It's just that they don't see it. And you might not even see it. But if you look close enough, inside yourself, you will find a little light. And I hold on to mine. And I'm asking, whoever you are, to hold on to yours. And maybe, just maybe, we will get to you through the process of being born and living, actually living.